Greetings. Muslims are not invited to watch this video. According to Sharia law, you are not allowed to know the truths it contains. As I have mentioned in previous videos, I believe there is ample evidence that Bashar al-Assad is the Mahdi. I have told you that, right? Darn! Okay, well, I was meaning to. Right after I tell you that Islam is the religion of the Antichrist. What? I've already told you that? Did I mention that he who denies the Father and the Son is of the Antichrist? That's actually from 1 John 2:22. So why do I think Bashar al-Assad is the Mahdi and Antichrist? Well, for quite a few reasons, actually. Let me lay them out for you. Revelation 13:2. And the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard. The beast spoken of here is the person called the Antichrist. And his feet were as the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion. And the dragon gave him his power, and his seat, and great authority. And the beast which I saw, the Arabic word wahash, means beast. His mouth as the mouth of a lion. The Arabic word Assad means lion. So why is the Arabic word wahash important? Because the Assad family name is al-wahash, meaning beast. And the father changed the family name from beast to, you got it, Assad, meaning lion. So the beast has a mouth as the mouth of a lion. He now calls himself Assad. And his feet were as the feet of a bear. The king of Syria has been supported by the Russian bear. Was like unto a leopard. To be honest, I'm still praying for discernment who or what the leopard is. But even as I was editing this video, the thought Persia kept coming to me, which is the ancient name for Iran. Remember, never ever call an Iranian an Arab. You'll likely start a fight. They are Persians. So the thought occurred to me, Google Persia leopard. Maybe African leopards were once found as far north as Iraq or Iran. And lo and behold, this is what came up from Google. Persian leopard. The Persian leopard is the largest leopard subspecies and native to eastern Turkey, the Caucasus Mountains, northern Iran, southern Turkmenistan, and parts of western Afghanistan. And I was thinking maybe some leopards once roamed somewhere in Iran. I was not thinking that a whole subspecies of leopard was identified directly as the Persian leopard. I think that establishes a very strong tie with Iran. So let us look at more evidence of the identity of this man. Daniel 7:8. I considered the horns, and behold, there came up among them another little horn. The little horn spoken of here is the person called the Antichrist. And behold, in this horn were eyes like the eyes of man. The King James says, and behold, in this horn were eyes like the eyes of man. That's what we just read. The NIV says, this horn had eyes like the eyes of a man. The New Living Translation, this little horn had eyes like human eyes. Dewey Rheims Bible. And behold, eyes like the eyes of a man were in this horn. I looked at all the translations on Biblos.com, and they all have this imagery, having eyes that looked like human eyes. I think you are free to reject the interpretation I am about to propose. Let's look a little closer at this phrase, eyes like the eyes of man. There it is in the Hebrew, and if you look at the underlying Hebrew words, they both come from the root word 5870, ayin. Here you can see the Strong's Concordance reference, numbered 5870. So I looked this word up in my Strong's Concordance, and this Hebrew word, number 5780, ayin, has meanings like eye, outward appearance, knowledge, regard, sight. It also has some other subtle variances of those words. So the various meanings have multiple combinations, having the word appear first and then second right after it, basically. And one of the possible meanings, or combinations of meanings, is he shall have knowledge of the eyes of men. That seems to make a little more sense to me than the imagery of the horn shall have the eyes like the eyes of a man, or eyes of men. And I think that is an interesting phrase. Speaking of the little horn, he shall have knowledge of the eyes of men. Before you look into it, what do you think Bashar al-Assad's profession was before he became king with the death of his father? A lawyer? No. Investor? No. Officer? No. Diplomat? No. This is taken from the wiki page. Initially, Bashar had few political aspirations. His father had been grooming Bashar's older brother, Basil al-Assad, as a future president. Bashar studied ophthalmology at Damascus University and arrived in London in 1992 to continue his studies. He was recalled in 1994 to join the Syrian army after Basil's death in an automobile accident. So Bashar al-Assad was an ophthalmologist. Ophthalmology is the branch of medicine which deals with the anatomy, physiology, and diseases of the eye. An ophthalmologist is a specialist in medical and surgical eye problems. Knowledge of men's eyes. Like I said, you are free to reject this interpretation, but I encourage you to watch closely the events in Syria. The Arab Spring is actually an Islamic uprising, not a democracy movement. In Reuters, about a week ago, Iran sees ally Syria surrounded by the U.S. and Arab wolves. Islamic, popular, and anti-American. Iran had hoped the Arab Spring, something Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei dubbed the Islamic Awakening, would spell the end of U.S.-backed autocracies and usher in an era of Muslim unity to face down the West and Israel. Khamenei used the June anniversary of the death of Iran's revolutionary leader to tell the nation, "Our stance is clear. Wherever a movement is Islamic, popular, and anti-American, we support it." So here twice in one article, this man says it is an Islamic awakening. While the leaders in the West want to claim all is well, the world of Islam sees this in a very different way. Islam sees this as an Islamic movement. And looking at the article, Iran is still a firm supporter of Syria and Bashar al-Assad. But what if it begins to look like al-Assad will be ousted? Really? You don't see that Syria will start the attack Israel chant? With very little coverage in American news, Syria has already tested a strategy in the recent months. June 5, 2001. Palestinians rush Israeli border from Syria. 11 people killed. So what if it looks like Assad is about to be ousted from power? What if he actually flees the country and goes to Iran for safety? Keep watching. Revelation 13:3. And I saw one of his heads, as it were, wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed, and all the world wondered after the beast. In fact, I'd like to go back a few verses and read Revelation 13 with this direction in mind. Revelation 13:1, "And I stood upon the sand of the sea, and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his heads the name of blasphemy." Here we see a beast rise up. I think this beast refers to the Islamic Empire that is coming. And the 7 heads and 10 horns describe how this Islamic Empire is comprised. But I will not state that I know the absolute specifics of the members. I am willing to go out on a limb and say the name of blasphemy is Allah or Islam. 13:2, "And the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard, and his feet were as the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion. And the dragon gave him his power and his seat and great authority." Here we see this verse in context. Remember it? Revelation 13:3, "And I saw one of his heads, as it were, wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed, and all the world wondered after the beast." There have been many theories and explanations of what this verse foretells and means. I remember some claiming this was Gorbachev's birthmark. Perhaps you do too. But I think it is worth considering that this refers to Assad being removed from power, as it were, wounded to death, and then returning to lead the Islamic Caliphate, his deadly wound was healed, against Israel. We shall certainly see if this is the correct understanding or not. I continue to watch events in Syria unfold, with an expectation that Assad runs to Iran, where he will be revealed to be the Mahdi. When or if you see these things begin to play out this way, prepare your hearts for what must surely follow. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.